So when people started to realize in the early part of the 1900s that Mendelian genetic existed and that it worked, then one of the things they started to do is look at all kinds of organisms and all kinds of characteristics to see whether Mendelian genetics was this grand universal answer to everything they ever wanted to know about genetics. And it turns out that when you come up with a really nice scheme, as Mendel did, and it appears to be working very well, it generally doesn't take very long until somebody finds something that they don't understand. Mendelian genetics, there it is, and this is how it's supposed to work, and here's my model organism, and it just doesn't seem to work at all. And so this next part deals with some of these perhaps anomalies where Mendelian genetics maybe doesn't give us all the answers. One of the questions when it comes to these universal answers to what happens in biology is that there are sometimes patterns that maybe don't perfectly work with what Mendel predicted, but maybe it's not that Mendel was wrong. Maybe we shouldn't throw out the whole idea. Maybe we should just look very carefully at how this new phenomenon works and then compare it in great detail with Mendelian genetics. There are these special cases. In fact, there are four of them that have to do with the genetics and one additional one that has not something to do with genetics. And these four are incomplete dominance, multi-allelic inheritance, pleiotropy, where a single gene affects several aspects of an individual, and the reverse of this, polygenic inheritance, where multiple genes affect a single trait. And so these four are things people identified, and what we're going to do is go through each of them with some examples to make you understand better how ultimately Mendelian genetics still wins out, but we just sometimes have to understand what exactly the condition is. So the first of these is called incomplete dominance. And in incomplete dominance, one of the issues is that the offspring don't have the phenotype of one of the parents, but they have a blended phenotype. Blended phenotype is not what we saw with the pea plants. There we had 100% of the pea plants be purple flowered, and the white just sort of disappeared for a bit, and then it came back in the second generation. So here we have this blending. Now the blending does not mean Mendel was wrong. It simply means that the particular aspect of how color is produced is a little bit different. Mendelian genetics still works, as you'll see. It just has something to do with the red and white color, in snapdragons in particular. So if we set this up just like Mendelian genetics and we start with the pure breeding red and the pure breeding white snapdragons, and then we form the gametes and we create the first filial generation, then you will see that they are all, 100% of them, pink. So the business about 100%, that's still Mendelian. So it tells us that some of this still works, it's just that the color doesn't work. Instead of having either the red or the white, the dominant one, emerges the single color, we have a mixture, we have pink. So what this means is that the red does not completely dominate the white, so white is still recessive, red is still dominant, but it's incomplete. So let's just accept that pink exists and that pink is the heterozygous version of this. And so this is an incomplete dominance. In incomplete dominance is the case where you have two alleles, a red allele and a white allele, produce three colors, red, white, and pink. But pink is when the two are mixed, so that's only in the heterozygous ones. And then you can confirm this by producing the F2 generation. You take your pink flowers and you allow them to interbreed. And when you do this, there's only so many ways you can create eggs and only so many ways you can create sperm. You use this whole thing as a multiplication table and ta-da, this is the second generation. And the second generation has these numbers quite predictably, so Mendelian genetics still works. It's just that the flower color doesn't quite work. And so rather than saying Mendelian genetics is wrong, what we need to do is accept that there are certain traits that become blended. Not all traits do this. Clearly the flower color in peas didn't, but the flower color in snapdragons does. And there are all kinds of plants you'll see that have two different flower colors, but there is incomplete dominance when it comes to color, and this incomplete dominance just happens. There are also other conditions, this is perhaps more relevant to us, where this kind of incomplete dominance happens with some of our traits. There is a disease called hypercholesterolemia, and hypercholesterolemia means that your cholesterol is not properly mopped up by your cells. Now, normally, your cells will have these so-called LDL receptors. LDL is one of the kinds of cholesterols. We all need cholesterol because it is important for our cell membranes. It is something we use to make hormones, but we only need a certain amount. And whatever we have in excess, we should have some way to remove it from the blood, because if we don't, then of course it can form plaques and, you know, obstruct our blood vessels and so on and so forth. So the normal cell exists in individuals that are homozygous dominant for the gene that makes LDL receptors. So this is the normal condition. If you look at the heterozygous individual, only has one functioning allele, the big H, that is the one that makes this LDL receptor, whereas the little h doesn't. So now, if you are heterozygous, that means you make some of these receptors, but you only make half of them. And half of them means you have a mild case of hypercholesterolemia, which means you have to be careful what you eat. You can mediate this by having a low cholesterol diet, and you'll probably be fine. But if you have both of the recessive alleles, so this would be your little h, that means your body cannot make any of these LDL receptors, so therefore they cannot mop up anything, and in addition to being careful with your diet, you really have to have something that removes the cholesterol from your bloodstream for you. Otherwise, you're always going to have high cholesterol. And so this is an indication where you have the same type of thing that you had with the flower colors and the snapdragons, but here it really matters. I mean, this is a real health issue. You need to have something, ideally, that helps you mop up these the additional LDL cholesterol. So that's incomplete dominance. Now, the second of these is a situation where we have multiple alleles. And in addition, we have something here called codominance. And the example we use here is the ABO blood group, which we have. Now, the ABO blood group gene